Hello there. Good to see so many of you here today. I'm Julia, an AI avatar created by Synthesia, and I was tasked to warm up the crowd with a joke. What is an AI's favorite music? Algorithms. Luckily, I'm not just here to tell jokes, but to introduce Synthesia's CEO and co-founder, Victor Riparbelli. The stage is all yours.
All right, we're live. Good to see so many of you here. I'm gonna give people just a few more seconds to join in, and then we're gonna get started talking about live collaboration. As always, we have a bunch of awesome people from Synthesia here in the chat. So if you have any questions while I'm talking, then just put them in the chat and we'll do our best to answer you as quickly as we can. I can't see the questions live, unfortunately, but I always read through them after. There's usually so many good questions, comments, ideas, so please don't be shy to use the chat box. But without further ado, let's get going. Live collaboration. I've been looking so much forward to releasing this feature. We've been working on it for almost a year. It's been a huge technical undertaking. For the last 3 or 4 months, we've been testing it internally and with some of our customers. And it truly is a game changer in terms of the workflow around creating videos. Before we go into the feature and why I hope it's going to be a game changer for you as well, then for those who are new, just want to quickly reiterate what Synthesia is about. So our mission is really simple, but hard. We want to make it easy for everyone to make video content. And the way we do that is by enabling you to make videos directly in your browser. You don't need cameras, studios, microphones, lights, actors, all that stuff. You just go into Synthesia, select your avatar, type up the script, edit the videos to your liking, and off you go. You've got a brand new, amazing video. You probably know us for the avatars and the voices, which is a big part of the product, but we have a bunch of other features that we've also built to make it as easy as possible to make videos. We have the AI video assistant, which we talked about last month's webinar, which enables you to go from an idea to a draft, let's say 70, 80% draft, in just a few seconds. You can give us a prompt, you can give it a document, or you can give it a web link. And from that, it'll take that content and it will write a script, design some basic scenes for you, and you can kind of edit it to your liking. Really cool feature. Check it out if you haven't already. Once you're done with your video, we also help you translate it. So we have one-click translation. We'll actually see that in action later today. And we also have an amazing bank of templates with all kinds of use cases and industries to get you started as quickly as possible. The reason we're so passionate about making video easy for everyone is because when we look at the online world today, people really want to watch and listen to content. They don't want to read that much anymore. Probably this is true for most of you out there in your private lives where nobody tells you what to do or what to watch. Most of us spend time on YouTube, TikTok, Netflix, listening to podcasts, and other forms of more kind of interactive types of media formats. I love reading, but for me, I only really buy the book if I'm really, really interested in a topic. I'll start off with podcasts and YouTube videos and TikToks and so on. And that makes total sense because biologically, we're just hardwired to better understand and engage with visual content, right? When we watch something, more of our senses are stimulated. We're hearing something, we're looking at something. It feels more like how we consume information in the real world. And so the effect of that is just that we're more engaged, and that increased engagement can turn into many different things. If you're doing education and training types of content, you'll have much higher information retention when people are engaged. They'll remember more of what they watch versus what they read. If you're doing marketing and sales, you're probably looking at things like conversion rates that you want to go up and just how much people engage your product. And video is by far the best format in many, many, many of these use cases. The issue is, however, that for most companies, and probably for a lot of companies you guys work in, only very few people in those companies can actually create videos, right? Probably something like 1% in most companies. And these video editors are the heroes, and we want to empower them as much as we can. But no matter how much and great tools we give video editors all around the world, they'll never be able to deal with the video demands of an entire organization that wants to make video content. And so that's why we're really building Synthesia to turn the 99% of the company into video creators. We want product managers to be able to make videos, IT managers to be able to make videos, HR leads to be able to make videos without necessarily having to go through a video editor every single time. And so that's very much what we're about here at Synthesia. and it goes very well with the feature we're going to be talking about today. The whole kind of collaboration part of Synthesia came from a year, 1.5 years ago, where we went out and we spoke to a lot of our awesome customers and asked them, hey, what can we do to make Synthesia a better product for you? And one of the things we kept hearing was that the tool is great, but the collaboration aspect of the product and finalizing a video essentially is not amazing, right? So we began on our collaboration roadmap. So now we have teams, workspaces, there's commenting functionality, you can share videos, a lot of the things that just makes it easier for a team to collaborate. I think that goes a really far way. But our customers kept telling us, look, like when we use other types of content creation tools, we're used to live collaboration, right? And we looked at Synthesia and how we work. We're like, that's actually true. Like most of the software suites we use to write things, design our product, are all built on live collaboration. So you probably all know Google Documents, where you can send a link to your colleagues, you can see each other's cursors, and you can actually write a document in real time. Figma is used by designers, where you have one file that everybody can working at the same time. Notion, there's so many products that have built in live collaboration. And it's such a game changer for how you work. And that's why we decided to also build this into Synthesia. We want this to be a tool that's used by everyone in the company, and we want it to be super smooth for everyone to collaborate. And so that's why we built live collaboration. It's been a big technical undertaking. It is, it's not an easy feat to take an app like this and make it sort of multiplayer. But we've done it, and I'm really excited to bring it out to all of you. We see live collaboration as having essentially three different components to it. There's the co-editing part, which is one I've just talked about. You can see each other's cursors. You can work together in real time. There's the commenting functionality. That's also new. So with commenting, we can comment on specific points in the video and specific scenes, which again just makes that kind of feedback flow much easier. And then last but not least, there's also the whole kind of sharing component of this. Once you've created the video and you want to translate it, for example, we want to make that as easy and smooth as possible. When we were putting together the materials for this webinar, we thought that actually the best way to talk about this would be to just use a real example from Synthesia. We of course make thousands of videos every single year, and we've very much had the pain of it being difficult to collaborate within ourselves. So today we're gonna kind of run it like this. We're gonna show you a video we're creating internally. It's a feature release video for the dialogue feature, which we released a few months ago. And as it's probably true for lots of you watching out here, when you're making a video, it's rarely just one person or one team that's involved. It's generally like a team effort, right? In our case here, we have the copy, the script, the narrative, how we talk about the product and the feature. That's generally done by the product marketing team. Here, that's going to be Vavara. Then once Vavara's kind of come up with the narrative and, you know, kind of come up with the script, essentially the core content of it, then we go to the design team. This is Adela in this case here. So Adela is going to make it look really smooth and polished and on brand and animations and like all the stuff that you want to make it look really sleek. Once we've done that and we have sort of a V1 contender for the video, it then goes to the product team to just look it over, make sure that everything is factually correct and everything is as it should look. Here we're going to be working with Anton today. And once Anton has approved it, we have a final version of the video. That's great, but it's in English. Now we want to translate it. And in Synthesia, the way we translate our videos is using our colleagues to speak those languages. So we'll also see that later today. First up though, let's look at the seamless co-editing, which is the live collaboration part of all this. So I'm going to jump into Studio. So here I have a video, which is just kind of a template. And I'll first up invite my colleague. So Vavara has already been invited. And I'll invite Adela in. Like this. They'll now get notification, and in just a second up here in the right hand corner we should see them pop into the video. There we see Vavara is coming in, and Adela should be coming in a second, and I can see her cursor, I can see which slide she's working on, and while we're waiting for Adela to come in, I'll just begin doing a bit of work here. I'll also name the video. Like this. Okay, so if we go down here, we can see Vavara's cursor moving around. She's adding in an image. She's moved the headline around a little bit. Adela up here, she added a space in the background. I'm guessing he's gonna add an avatar. There we go. Basically putting together like all the sort of visual components of this and so on and so forth. Of course, you can use every feature inside Studio in multiplayer as well. Nothing really changes there. So I could go down here and I could begin typing, hello, this is how you can use this feature. Customer support. And Bavara can edit that later if she wants to. And so on and so forth, right? So the full sort of creation experience is of course available in this live collaboration. Okay, so now the video is getting finished up and we can move to the next stage of the collaboration process. For us, the way this works is that product is gonna go in. So we're gonna be working with Anton from the product team to just put down the last kind of feedback, approve the content, make sure everything is exactly the way it should be. So let's jump into Studio again with a slightly more finished video. The first thing I'm gonna do here is of course to invite Anton. So I'll invite Anton here. Anton should now be on his way in. And while he's coming in, I'll just put a few comments myself in the video. So maybe on this one here, I wanna question if this should be the right avatar. So I'll click the commenting button up here, click on the canvas, the scene here, and then I will put in a comment saying, Anton, should we switch this avatar out with Alex? So now I've posted the comment, and as you can see, it's both on the canvas here if I hover over it, but I can also see it over here to the right because I have the commenting lane active. Let's see, I can see down here that Anton is typing. So maybe he'll respond to my comment if we're lucky. And there's actually already a reply. Yep, agree, Alex would fit the scene better. That's pretty great. So now we both agree on it, right? We've done that feedback loop. So instead of me just leaving that comment there, like now we actually agreed in real time. So why don't I just switch out the avatar? That's probably easier for all of us, right? And we solved that bottleneck in literally 15 seconds instead of going back and forth with lots of comments. This of course goes for many other things as well. You can go up here, let's make a comment on, let's say how to, should we say insert instead of add hands on here, and so on and so forth, right? So this is also just really powerful in terms of getting those videos into that final state without having to go back and forth a million times on feedback. And because Anton got a notification, you can see he's already on the slide, he's working on it, and he's probably gonna reply in just a second. So this is the second phase of the comment and review phase. Now, let's say we've ironed out those comments. We all agree that the video is in a great state, but we wanna translate it, right? How do we do that? Well, if we go back into our video here in its final state after it's been generated, the first thing we wanna do here is to translate it. So we use the auto translate feature here. I will pick Korean and I'll pick Spanish to begin with. Click translate. And what's happening now is that the Synthesia translation engine is taking the videos. It's translating, of course, the script, which is the most important part, but it's also translating all of the text elements that you have in your scenes. So if we open up the Korean version here, you'll see it's in Korean now, both the text here and the text on the canvas. So I'm gonna invite Yuni from my team in because at Synthesia, we always translate videos with our colleagues and Yuni is Korean. Unfortunately, I don't speak Korean. So she'll now have received the invitation and hopefully she'll be in here in just a second and she can make some changes. For example, we have the title here, which is in English. Maybe she wants to change that. She's also changing the title here. And this is again, a very sleek process because she already is working with a machine translation that's probably pretty good. And she just needs to kind of like look through the video, make sure that it all sounds and feels natural to someone who actually speaks the language. This we can of course do with all our languages as well. So for the French one, I'd invite Pierre from the team. The Spanish one, I'd invite someone else. And it's again, just like this easy thing where you don't have to send it out, translate it, get someone else to review it. It all just happens on the platform. And when Yuni has made the changes that she thinks needs to be changed, we can render the video and we can essentially get it out there. So that's how we do it inside Synthesia. We use our colleagues to help us translate the videos. But speaking to our clients, a lot of our clients are using the collaboration features with external partners as well, which can be really powerful. So if you're not so lucky that you have someone on your team who speaks the language, or maybe you need to have professional grade translation, then what we see a lot of our customers do is invite the translation agencies into the platform and just do the changes themselves. So again, instead of downloading the video, sending out an email, waiting for feedback, implementing that back into the video, the translation agency can do that directly in the platform, which is really powerful. There's also legal advisors for a lot of companies, like when you produce marketing materials, for example, that has to go through a legal review, you can now just invite them in here instead of going back and forth. PR agencies, consultants, et cetera, et cetera. So you save yourself from the headache of WeTransfers, email chains, and all those things that otherwise would go into collaborating without having a platform like Synthesia at hand. For now, the live collaboration features is only available on the enterprise plans, but there's a bunch of these features that's also available on the self-service part of it. So one of the things we've been working on implemented is the commenting functionality, which has precise comments. So once you've generated the video and you're at the screen that you're seeing right now, you can leave comments on a video which are time coded, right? So precise comments means that if you make a comment 17 seconds into the video or a minute or 2 minutes into the video, it will kind of be tagged, and the person who's reading that comment can then see when you made the comment. So again, this just makes it easier. And again, you can use this with externals, you can use it with your own team, and it gives you that functionality to just keep the collaboration part of your work inside of the Synthesia platform. So to summarize, before and without live collaboration, lots of feedback on Slack, Teams, emails, Zoom, back and forth all the time. Not a great workflow for anyone, and just wastes many, many hours and many, many brain cycles. The second issue with not having live collaboration and collaboration on the platform is that very often that means that a single tweak depends on the video editor, right? So you have like 7 people all coming back with comments and things they want to change in the video, and then it's one video editor, one expert that then needs to go and implement those changes. That's very tiresome and also leads to people making less comments, frankly, because you don't want to overburden the video editors. That's a slow and inefficient process. With live collaboration, what you can do now is, again, bring people into the same link, jump on a call, iron out real time. Everybody can go in and make changes. There's, of course, still changes you want to have an expert or video editor do, but if it's just like small typos, the way you phrase something, then everyone can just go in, do it for themselves, correct the translation to script, and all the stuff. And that really just gives you better team alignment, much faster production time, and way higher quality of videos, because it's just easier to implement those changes and iterate your way to the exact right video. So that's all for live collaboration. Please give us feedback. Let us know what you think, how we can improve it. Super important to us. What's next? Spaces launched a few weeks ago. That's the ability to put your avatar in a nice space, like an office or medical ward. This is, of course, just V1. We're working on making this even more interactive and even more realistic. Put your avatars in actual environments. It's going to be super cool. Keep an eye out for that. Next webinar is going to be a really, really big one. It's going to be about expressive avatars. We've given you guys a sneak peek of what this looks like already, but just in the last month, they've gotten so much better. And I'm very, very, very excited to show you just how lifelike and real we've pushed them to be. We also have a magic screen recorder coming up. I won't say too much about that, but we know that screen recordings is a huge part of a lot of you all's workflow inside of Synthesia, and we want to make that easier. So we've been working on some technology that it makes it easier to record your screen using AI, and we're going to be talking more about that very soon. Thank you for tuning in. Great to see so many people here. Love all the comments and questions. Can't wait to read them after we go off the live. See you very soon, and thank you all.